सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिनी व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण्डजातिपुरं यदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुं हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुरोऽयि शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। आम्ना यान्तिकसं सिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमा पूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। The last adhikarana in this pada is apratikalambana adhikaranam, where after establishing that the karya brahma is the one which is the destination for upasakas, itham archiradi gantavim nirupya gantrunam buddhisthatvat. After establishing the marga, the Bhagavan Sutrakara established the destination for the upasakas. Now, having established the upasakas, having described them, archiradi gantavyam, by the archiradi marga, the gantavya destination is brahmaloka karya brahma. Having described that, nirupya gantrunam, the upasakas who are travelers, gantrunam buddhistatvat. So, who are these who are traveling? That is the question. Upasakas only or others also? And in upasakas also, which upasaka? All the upasakas or only some particular type of upasakas will have brahma loka prapti? That question comes to mind. It is in the buddhi. Therefore, buddhistha is the sangati, buddhistattvam. Buddhistattva sangatya tan nirupayitum idamaha. Since this question has come up in the mind with that kind of a sangati, the last adhikarana is brought up. And there the sutra is apratikalambanat nayati iti badarayana ubhayata doshat tatkratuscha. Apratikalambanat nayati iti badarayana ubhayata doshat tatkratuscha. Here there is no purvapaksha mentioned initially, so we look at that before the sutrartha. Atra purvapakshe upasaka matrasya uttaramarga siddhihi. Siddhanti tu ubhayata उभयथा भाव सिद्धिरिति फलभेदः। सो पूर्वपक्षी सेज उपासक मात्र, जस्ट बाय बीइंग उपासक, व्हाट कैन उपासक इज नॉट रियली अ कंसर्न एट ऑल। इफ द पर्सन इज एन उपासक, आफ्टर मरणा ही विल गेट ब्रह्मलोक, दैट्स ऑल। इट इज इरिलेवेंट वेदर इट इज प्रतीक उपासक और अहंग्र उपासक, मीनिंग द हिरण्यगर्भ उपासक। There is no difference there, says the Purvapakshi. Siddhanti says there is vishesha there as to which upasaka attains brahmaloka. There is a difference. Not all upasakas will attain, meaning pratika upasakas, those who do pratika upasana, they won't get brahmaloka. They'll get ishta devata or the pratika or merging with the pratika or whatever is a specific phala based on the pratika upasana. So, mano brahmetyupasita or nama brahmetyupasita, in such upasanas, pratika he is having gradations. So, where there is gradations, the phala will also have gradations. Brahmaloka is the ultimate phala for the upasaka, and that is possible only when the upasana is with the brahma drishti, not with the upasya pratika drishti. So, if you are an upasaka, says the Siddhanti to the Purvapaksha, as to you are looking upon, say you worshipping the stone as the Lord is fine, but then you are looking at limited features, as to you are looking at Salagrama, and Salagrama is the Pratika, therefore it will become Pradhana, and in the Salagrama you have Vishnu Drishti, only Vishnu, not Shiva Drishti. एंड इन शिवलिंगा यू हैव शिव दृष्टि, यू डोंट हैव विष्णु दृष्टि और समष्टि ईश्वर दृष्टि, देयर फॉर द फलाव इज लिमिटेड. इफ यू सी दिस परमेश्वर हिमसेल्फ एज मैनिफेस्ट एज शिवा, यू डोंट सी डिफरेंस, एंड देन यू आर डूइंग परमात्मा पूजा, दैट्स अ डिफरेंट मैटर. बट इन प्रतीको उपासना सिमिलरली इज द केस ऑफ प्रतीको उपासना, वेयर पर्टिक्युलर मनस और पर्टिक्युलर नाम इज द निकृष्ट इन विच उत्कृष्ट दृष्टि इज मेड. देर नाम ब्रह्म इत्युपासन इत्यादि, देर प्रतीका इज आलंबना बिकम्स प्रधान, एंड देर द फला विल ऑल्सो बी लिमिटेड बिकॉज देर आर लिमिटेशंस इन प्रतीकाज इन द अधिष्ठान, वेर यू हैव ब्रह्म दृष्टि ऑल्सो, बट स्टिल द उपास्य विल बिकम लिमिटेड. And phala mentioned is also limited in that particular section. There are gradations across various pratikas, and therefore pratika upasana gradations are there and phala gradations are there. They won't get, those upasakas will not get brahmaloka. So ubhayata abhava siddhi we'll see as we go further. Meaning Purvapakshi is going to bring up some paksha as to earlier you have said this, there will be virodha with that. So Siddhanti says no, there is no issue there. So that is Ubhayata. That Ubhayata meaning we'll see in the as the vritti progresses. So apratika alambanat nayati iti badarayanah Ubhayata adoshat tatkratuscha tatkratuhu cha. So tatkratu is a samasa there. That is a padachheda. So what is the Purvapaksha? All upasakas, upasaka matra, meaning pratika upasana or apratika upasana, ahangra upasana or hirangare upasanas, those who are doing, they are upasaka matra. So upasaka matra means all upasakas, they will get brahmaloka. So uttaramarga siddhi. Siddhanti says no, apratika alambana, alambanat, apratika alambanat nayati. अप्रतीक आलंबनात नयति इति बादरायण. बादरायण आचार्य सिद्धांती कंसीडर्स दैट देर इज अप्रतीक आलंबन, मीनिंग प्रतीक उपासना हु आर डूइंग दे हैव प्रतीक एज आलंबन. सो प्रतीक आलंबन प्रतीकम आलंबनम येषाम, दे आर व्हाट प्रतीक आलंबन आलंबना बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट इज दी अन्य पद, व्हाट वुड दी अन्य पद हियर. सो इन अप्रतीक आलंबनान हैज बीन मेंशन, प्रतीक अप्रतीक आलंबनान नयति. नो आई सेड आलंबनात, नॉट आलंबनात, आलंबनान, आई मेड अ मिस्टेक देयर. सो अप्रतीक आलंबनान नयति, आलंबनान आर उपासकान. सो अप्रतीक आलंबनान उपासकान नयति इति बादरायणः मन्यते, बादरायण आचार्य मन्यते. सो अप्रतीक आलंबना आन दि अन्य पद विल बी पुल्लिंग उपासकास. सो प्रतीकम आलंबनम येषाम उपासकानाम, ते उपासकाः प्रतीक आलंबनाः, देन तान प्रतीक आलंबनान वुड बी द सेकंड केस. बट अप्रतीक एज मेंशन, सो यू हैव टू डू नंज देयर, नंज बहुरी और नंज तत्पुरुष बोथ आर पॉसिबल. इफ यू मेक अ नंज बरोवरी देन यू हैव टू से अप्रतीक मीनिंग अविद्यमान अविद्यमानम प्रतीकम आलंबनम येषाम. बेटर वेज टू डू इज प्रतीक आलंबन यू लैंड ऑन फर्स्ट एंड देन यू से न प्रतीक आलंबन दे आर अप्रतीक और नंज बहुवरी इज फाइन. विद नंज तत्पुरुष ऑल्सो यू हैव टू एक्सप्लेन समथिंग एज टू नॉन प्रतीक आलंबन उपासकास. बट हियर वी आर सेइंग दैट दे आर उपासकास, they are not non upasaka. So bahuri would be better. So you have to say avidyamanam pratikam alambanam yesham te, or avidyamanam pratika alambanam yesham te apratika alambana. Those who do not have their upasya alambana as pratika, they are what, they are ahangra upasakas or saguna brahma hiranyagarbha upasakas, those are the ones who will get ब्रह्मलोका प्राप्ति. वाय बिकॉज नयति, दे अलोन आर टेकन बाय अमानव पुरुष फ्रॉम विद्युल्लोका टू ब्रह्मलोका आर लेड ओनली are led by Amanava. Who are those? Those who have reached there are only apratikalamban upasakas, not pratikalamban upasakas. Why? So ubhayata adoshat tatkratushes. Ubhayata adoshat cannot be understood without some sangati there. So that we'll see in the vritti. And tatkratushcha also they'll go together. We'll see. Tatkratuhu will mean tasya kare brahmanah kratuhu upasanam. Yes, sir. So the upasaka, satkratushya means tatkratuhu is the upasaka who tasya kratu, one who is performer of that karma. That karma is manasika karma, upasana. So tatkratushcha, upasakascha, that is the meaning there. And ubhayata adoshat we'll see with some sangati in the vritti. अत्र पूर्वपक्षे उपासक मात्रस्य उत्तरमार्ग सिद्धि सिद्धान्ते तु उभयथा भाव सिद्धिरिति फलभेदः किम अमानवः पुरुषः सर्वान् उपासकान् ब्रह्मलोकं नयति उत अप्रतिकालम्बनान् इति संदेहे. व्हेन देयर इज अ डाउट एज टू हु आर लेड बाय दी अमानव पुरुष, आर दीज पीपल हु हैव रीच्ड विद्युल्लोका, They are they all upasaka, sarvan upasaka nayati, therefore he takes all of them to Brahmaloka, or only apratikalambana. Now, whether all of them have reached vidyulloka, they are what kind of upasakas, that inquiry can be separate. Meaning, those who have reached there with some vidyulloka phala mentioned, they may be pratika upasakas also. We do not know all the upasana. So if there is an upasana phala where vidyut loka prapti is there, we have seen in the earlier patha as to Brahma loka itself has various sections in terms of swarga ityadi. So there all these, you know, particular sections where they have reached, they already reached. From there, if one has to go to proper Brahma loka, as in where the krama mukti is possible, then the segmentation has to be made. As to Amanav Purusha will take only those upasakas who are doing Saguna Brahma Upasanas, who have done Saguna Brahma Upasana or Ahangra Upasana, they are the ones who will be led to Brahma Loka. Uta Apratika Alambananiti, this is a Siddhanta Paksha. Iti Sandehe Niyamaka Bhavat Sarvaniti Purva Paksha. Since there is no rule mentioned there, because Amanava Purusha is just taking everyone to Brahma Loka, therefore there is no niyama, and therefore all upasakas will be led to Brahmaloka. That is their phala, that is the purva paksha. Siddhantastu apratika alambanan pratika upasaka bhinnan. So apratika alambanan are what? They are different from the pratika alambana upasakas, meaning pratika upasakas. Upasakan nayati amanava iti badarayana acharya manyati. Badarayana acharya Vedante says that only apratika alambana upasakas, meaning those upasakas who are different from pratika alambana upasakas, meaning their upasana is not pratika upasana, it is ahangraha or hiranyagarbha upasana, they are the ones who are led to brahmaloka. To this there is an objection. Nanu tarhi aniyamaha sarvasam aniyamas sarvasam ityatra sarvopasaneshu margopasamara krutaha. You have already mentioned in Aniyamaha Sarvasam, all upasakas go to Brahmaloka, there is no niyama. This is your own Siddhanta, says the Purvapakshi. This is how he has understood earlier in earlier sutra, some sutra earlier across sections in the different pada altogether. So there, Sarvopasaneshu Margopasamhara Krita, you have said that all upasakas go by the same marga. In that Aniyama Sarvasam, there the Marga Upasamhara was done. You have concluded by refuting all Purva Paksha as to there is only single Marga. When was this seen? In the earlier Pada, when we saw as to all different Visheshanas were given to Marga. As per the Siddhanti, Purva Pakshi said that these are different Margas altogether because they are in different Prakaranas. Siddhanti says no, these are just different Visheshanas for the same Uttarayana Marga. The Uttara Marga is what is meant by Archiradi or different names which are used, Uttarayana Marga. These are all Visheshanas of the same Marga. Why? Because destination goal is Brahmaloka. Now it says Aniyama Sarvasam Ityatra. There, in that sutra, Sarva Upasaneshu Marga Upasamhara Krita. बाय हूम सिद्धांति ना बाय सिद्धांति इटसेल्फ हिमसेल्फ द मार्ग वॉज शोन टू बी अ सिंगल मार्ग विथ वेरियस विशेषणास वेरियस नेम्स बट इट इज अ सिंगल मार्ग फॉर ऑल उपासकास नाउ तद विरोध इत्यतः देयर इज अ विरोध टू दैट सूत्र एंड टू युअर ओन इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ द सूत्र एंड रिफ्यूटेशन ऑफ द पूर्वपक्षी इफ दिस इज द केस टू दैट इत्यतः सिद्धांति आंसर्स नो उभयता दोषात उभयता दोषाच मीनिंग उभयथा अभ्युपगमे अदोषात दोषाभाव दिस संग्रह वाक्य मीनिंग इट विल बी एलाबोरेटेड उभयता इन बोथ वेज देर इज नो दोष वेन वी से दैट ऑल उपासकास गो टू ब्रह्मलोक वॉट वी मेंट देयर बाय सिंगल पाथ ऑल दोज उपासकास हु आर डूइंग अहंग्रह उपासना दैट इज वॉट वी मेंट सो अनियम अनियम न्यायस्य प्रतीक भिन्न विषयकत्वात् न तद विरोध सो वेन वी मेंट दैट देर इज नो सच रूल एज टू डिफरेंट मार्गास वॉट वी मेंट इज दैट द फाइनल डेस्टिनेशन ब्रह्मलोका इज नॉट कॉमन इट इज कॉमन ओनली टू प्रतीक भिन्न उपासका सो प्रतीक भिन्न उपासकास आर वॉट वी आर डिस्कसिंग एंड इफ द मार्ग इज सेम इट डज नॉट मीन द डेस्टिनेशन इज सेम दैट इज द आइडिया as to marga may be same but the stops are different as to in brahmaloka also there is division made as to swarga or you can consider it as a different loka and it is in the same uttarayana marga in uttarayana marga itself you'll have in uttar marga itself you'll have the swarga loka also and brahmaloka is the final destination not all upasakas reach there only the apratika upasakas reach there अत्र नियामकामाः सो व्हाट इज द रूल देयर तत्क्रतुश्च सो तत्क्रतुश्च मीन्स तस्य कार्यब्रह्मणः क्रतुः उपासनं यस्य सः तत्क्रतुः सो दैट इज द आइडिया नाउ हियर उभयता अदोषात मीन्स उपासक भेदेन अदोषात दैट इज व्हाट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड देयर अदोष इज ड्यू टू उपासक अभेद एंड दिस इज द meaning what as to what Badarayana Acharya considers the destination to be for whom the destination of Brahmaloka is then what is this tatkratuscha so there it is said tatkratuscha means tasya kratuhu cha tasya kratu tasya kasya tasya karya brahmana so karya brahmana kratu mean kratu is upasanam yes one who has the upasana kratuhu which is tat tat meaning तस्य कार्य ब्रह्मण ऑफ दैट कार्य ब्रह्म दैट पर्सन उपासक इज कॉल्ड एज तत्क्रतु हिज उपासक एवंच यो यद विषयक उपासक स तत् प्राप्नोति इति श्रुति स्मृति सिद्धत्वात् तद उपासकानाम एव कार्य ब्रह्म प्राप्ति सो सिद्धांति फाइनली कंक्लूड्स बाय सेइंग दैट दिस इज अ वेल नोन न्याय एज टू व्हाट इज द विषय ऑफ विच उपासक दैट इज द विषय दैट ही अटेन If there is an Ishta Devata whose Upasana one is doing, then one will attain that Ishta Devata. This is very well known. So why would you consider that this is any different? Based on that Nyaya, if the Upasaka is Karya Brahma Upasaka, then he will attain Karya Brahma. If he is non-Karya Brahma Upasaka, then he will attain a different Loka or a different Devata. This is Shruti and Smriti Siddha. And therefore, श्रुति स्मृति सिद्धत्वात् तद उपासकानाम एव कार्य ब्रह्म प्राप्त तद उपासकानाम कार्य ब्रह्म उपासकानाम एव अप्रतीक उपासकानाम एव कार्य ब्रह्म प्राप्ति देयरफॉर देयर इज नो इश्यू एट ऑल देयर प्रतीक उपासनेषु नाम ब्रह्म इत्यादिषु ब्रह्मण प्रतीकं प्रति विशेषणत्वेन प्रतीकस्य एव प्राधान्यात् न तद उपासकानाम ब्रह्म प्राप्ति What happens to Pratika Upasaka? So there Pratika Upasana that they are following, there Nama Brahma Ityadishu, such Upasanas where Nama Brahma, Mano Brahma, such kind of instruction is such kind of instructions are there. Thereby what happens is that Brahmana Pratikam Prati Visheshanatvena. So Brahma becomes Visheshana whereas Vishesha is the Pratika. So pratika becomes pradhana in pratika upasana and therefore what happens there is that Brahma is not the upasya at all. The pratika is upasya. प्रतीकस्य एव प्राधान्यात् प्रतीक बिकम्स विशेष्य एंड प्रधान एंड देयर बाय न तद उपासकानां ब्रह्म प्राप्ति ही दोज उपासकास डू नॉट गेट ब्रह्म व्हाई बिकॉज दे गेट द प्रतीक दे अटेन द प्रतीक प्राधान्य और वॉट एवर फल इज मेंशन्ड देयर स्पेसिफिकली दैट इज वॉट दे गेट एंड देयर बाय देर इज नो ब्रह्म प्राप्ति और ब्रह्मलोक प्राप्ति फॉर देम फर्दर ऑल्सो उभयता इन बोथ वेज वेदर यू सी इट माई वे एज टू ओनली अप्रतीक उपासना और वी सी द मार्गा बींग सेम इन बोथ वेज मार्गा बींग सेम ऑल्सो देर इज नो इशू देर एज टू प्रतीकाज आर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अप्रतीक उपासना वाइज एंड देर फॉर उपासक वाइज ऑल्सो देर इज अ डिफरेंस उपासक भेदेन उभयता इज उपासक भेदेन डिवाइडिंग द उपासकाज हु आर ट्रेवलिंग In twofold way, adosha. There is no dosha in the earlier sutra, aniyama sarvasam also there. What we have used, there is no dosha there. This is the meaning of ubhayata there. Ubhayata adosha. And tatkartuscha is upasakascha. So upasakascha is upasaka is separate there. Upasaka is the, what do you say, the tatkartuhu, तत्क्रतु तत्क्रतु न्याय सो यू कैन से तत्क्रतु न्याय मीनिंग यद्यद् उपासते तत्तदेव भवति दैट इज तत्क्रतु न्याय सो दैट इज कोटेड बाय तत्क्रतुश्च इट रिमाइंड्स अस ऑफ दिस उपासका इज गोइंग टू गेट फला बेस्ड ऑन हिज उपासना सो उपासक भेद इज देयर सो तत्क्रतु न्याय टेल्स यू दैट व्हाटएवर वन मेडिटेट्स अपॉन दैट विषय वन अटेन्स पंचाग्नि उपासक नाउ द पूर्वपक्षी सेज बट यू हैव सेड दैट पंचाग्नि उपासक इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू अटेन ब्रह्मलोक ही मे हैव पुनरावृत्ति एज पर द पंचाग्नि विद्या जर्नी बट देन यू हैव सेड दे अटेन ब्रह्मलोक ब्रह्मलोक स्वर्गलोक देयर सिंस स्वर्गलोक इज ऑल्सो कंसिडर्ड एज पार्ट ऑफ ब्रह्मलोक इन वन पर्सपेक्टिव सो पंचाग्नि उपासक विल अटेन ब्रह्मलोक दिस इज ही मेंशन देयर एज टू सिद्धांती हैज कंक्लूडेड दिस वाज सीन अर्लियर ऑल्सो पंचाग्नि विद्या उपासक हैज ऑल्सो अटेन ब्रह्मलोक इन द सेम द अनियम सर्वासाम देयर वी हैड सीन सो पूर्व पक्षी ब्रिंग्स दैट टू दिस क्वेश्चन इन अ डिबेट एज टू पंचाग्नि उपासकांच अब्रह्म उपासकत्वे अपि पंचाग्नि इन दैट पंचाग्नि विद्या व्हाट इज द उपासना देर आर फाइव डिफरेंट आहुतीज फाइव डिफरेंट अग्निज इन फाइव डिफरेंट आहुतीज आर कंसिडर्ड एंड दैट इज व्हाट वन इज डूइंग उपासना ऑफ देन व्हाई वुड यू थिंक दैट देर इज ब्रह्मलोक प्राप्ति बिकॉज देर उपास्य आर डिफरेंट एट फाइव स्टेप्स नोवेयर इज द ब्रह्म उपास्य देर So they are also Abrahma Upasakas. Why would they get Brahma Loka? It is a very valid question. To that Siddhanti says, Panchagni Upasakanam cha Abrahma Upasakatvyapi. Yes, we do agree that their Upasya is not Brahma. Then Tatkratunyaya should apply. They are Abrahma Upasakas. They should not attain Brahma Loka. They should attain Abrahma something. To that Siddhanti says, Shruti Balad Brahma Praptirithi Viveka. There is a specific mention as to they'll attain Brahma Loka. Therefore, Shruti is the pramana there, although logically what you say is right, but Shruti says that Brahma Prapti is the phala, whereas in the other upasanas as to Pratika upasanas, there is absolutely no mention of Brahma Prapti. So Shruti does not say that they get Brahma, it gives a different phala. So those phalas are not Brahma Loka anyway, and therefore there will be particular mentioned phala in the Shruti. For Pratika Upasakas. This Panchagni Upasana is at a tangent, meaning it is an exception to the general Tatkratu Nyaya, and thereby Shruti will supersede that Nyaya. And when there is no doubt there, Shruti itself is saying that they'll get Brahmaloka, then we need not question it at all. This is the Veka. Apicha. Further, what? Visheshancha Darshayati. Visheshancha Darshayati. So visheshancha darshayati, there is also some particular result mentioned. The Shruti shows that result. So Shruti hi darshayati. What is that? यावन नामनो गतं तत्रास्य यथा कामचारो भवति इति नाम प्रतीक उपासन फलाद उत्तरोत्तर वागादि उपासना नाम उत्कृष्ट फल विशेषम दर्शयति। दिस उकार मे बी मिसिंग, देयर इज अ टाइपो इन द अर्लियर, सो इफ यू हैव प्रिंटेड बिफोर देयर विल बी नो उकार हियर। सो यावन नामनो गतम तत्रस्य यथा कामचारो भवति, यथा कामचार इज अ विशेष फला दैट श्रुति शोज दर्शयति। फॉर हुम? फॉर अ प्रतीक उपासक। सो यावन नामनो गतम इज वॉट हैज बीन मेन्शंड इन दी मंत्र इन दी छांदोग्य सप्तम अध्याय। सो देर दी श्रुति गिव्स अ पर्टिकुलर फल यथा कामचारो होती, वॉट एवर ही विशेस ही गेट्स। सो देर इज अ डिफरेंस इन और ग्रेडेशन इन फला मेन्शंड। सो दिस इज जस्ट वन वन मंत्र कोटेड आउट ऑफ अ सेक्शन। सो वन हु यावन नामना इज वन हु मेडिटेट्स अपॉन नाम एज ब्रह्म। सो नाम ब्रह्म, वन हु मेडिटेट्स अपॉन नाम एज ब्रह्म, दिस इज वॉट सनत कुमार टॉट नारद मुनि। सो आचार्य सनत कुमार आचार्य टॉट नारद मुनि एज टू नाम ब्रह्म इत्युपासितः। सो यावन नामना गतम, वन हु हैज डन दिस काइंड ऑफ एन उपासना, यावन नाम उपासना, सो गतम तत्र अस्य वॉट इज ए फल यथा कामचारः भवति, ही विल बिकम यथा कामचार मीन्स वॉट एवर ही विशेस ही गेट्स, दैट इज द काइंड ऑफ फल दैट दी नाम ब्रह्म उपासक गेट्स। सो यथेच्छा गति, यथा कामचार यथेच्छा यथेच्छा ही गेट्स गति इति नाम प्रतीक उपासना फलाद। आफ्टर डिस्कसिंग दिस, आफ्टर स्टेटिंग द फला फॉर दी नाम प्रतीक बीइंग सीन एज ब्रह्म, सो नाम प्रतीक उपासना, इट्स अ प्रतीक उपासना, अ पर्टिकुलर नाम उपासना। सो पर्टिकुलर रादर पर्टिकुलर प्रतीक उपासना वेयर नाम इज सीन एज ब्रह्म। आफ्टर दैट फल व्हाट डज इट श्रुति से उत्तरोत्तर वागादि उपासना नाम उत्कृष्ट फल विशेषम दर्शयति। एज यू गो फ्रॉम सेक्शन टू सेक्शन अहेड यू विल सी डिफरेंट प्रतीकास बीइंग मेंशनड एंड डिफरेंट दृष्टि ब्रह्म दृष्टि इन डिफरेंट प्रतीकास एंड दे गिव हायर रिजल्ट्स। सो वागादि, सो इन नाम ऑल्सो देर वागेन्द्र इज सुपीरियर टू नाम, सो वाग प्रतीक बिकम सुपीरियर टू नाम एंड इन दैट इफ यू हैव दृष्टि देर इज अन उत्कृष्ट फल। सो वागादि उपासना नाम उत्कृष्ट फल विशेषम दर्शयति। देर इज सुपीरियर फल इवन कंपेयर टू नाम, नाम इज द फर्स्ट इन द प्रतीक उपासना इन दैट सेक्शन। देन देर इज अनदर वाग, वाग उपासना, इन वाक देर इज उत्कृष्ट दृष्टि, इट गिव्स सुपीरियर फल टू नाम हैविंग ब्रह्म दृष्टि। सो दिस इज वॉट श्रुति शोज वागवाव नाम भूय भूयसी इत्याद्या श्रुति ही। सो देर इज अ श्रुति विच इज दैट कंपेयर टू नाम, नाम वाक, सो वागवाव इट सेज दैट दी वाक इज वाव इंडीड वाक इज सुपीरियर टू नाम भूयसी। वाक वाक इज स्त्रीलिंग, सो भूयसी सुपीरियर टू वॉट नामनः कंपेयर टू नाम इत्याद्या श्रुति। सो फला इज ऑल्सो विशेष, सम विशेष फला इज देयर, सम सुपीरियर फला इज देयर टू दी वाक प्रतीक उपासक कंपेयर टू नाम प्रतीक उपासक। अयंच फल विशेष प्रतीकानाम उत्कर्ष अपकर्षवताम उपास्यत्वे युज्यते। सो दिस इज दिस फला उत्कर्ष सुपीरियरिटी इन फला ग्रेडेशन इन फला इज लॉजिकल और टेनेबल ओनली वेन देर इज उप उत्कर्ष उत्कर्ष अपकर्ष देर इज ग्रेडेशन और देर आर हायर देर आर देर इज अ हायरार्की ऑफ सुपीरियरिटी एंड इन्फीरियरिटी अमांग प्रतीकास। सो प्रतीकानाम उत्कर्ष अपकर्षवताम उपास्यत्वे युज्यते। वेन वन इज डूइंग उपासना ऑफ प्रतीकास वेर प्रतीकास हैव ग्रेडेशन देर फोर दि फला हैव ग्रेडेशन दिस इज टेनेबल न तो सर्वत्र एक रूपस्य ब्रह्मण उपास्यत्वे। इफ दि उपासना इज बीइंग डन ऑन ब्रह्म वेर यू से नाम ब्रह्म इत्युपासित और वाक ब्रह्म इत्युपासित यू कंसीडर ब्रह्म इज कॉमन टू बोथ इफ द ब्रह्मत्व दृष्टि इज देयर एंड ब्रह्म बिकम्स उपास्य देन देयर वोंट बी ग्रेडेशंस फला कैन नॉट हैव ग्रेडेशंस हाउएवर द उपास्य प्राधान्य विशेष्य इज द नाम और वाक वेर देर इज ग्रेडेशन इन प्रतीक देयर फोर फला ग्रेडेशन इज देयर इफ ब्रह्मत्व is there brahmatva drishti is there meaning brahma becomes upasya then there won't be any gradations but shruti shows of gradations in phala and that is because there is gradation in pratika and therefore pratika upasak upasakas will get vishesha phala gradations in phala and it is not brahmaloka because brahma is common if brahma is common across all upasanas then phala would have been brahma But Brahma is not upasya. There is no commonality across all these upasanas. In pratika upasanas, there is gradations in pratika and therefore in phala. And none of these phalas are Brahmaloka. Tasmad Brahma upasakanam eva Brahma prapti na pratika upasakanam iti siddham. Therefore, it has been concluded well as to Brahma upasaka will get Brahma prapti. Only Brahma upasakas will get Brahma prapti. But pratika upasakas will get tat tat phala. देर रिस्पेक्टिव विशेष फला इति श्रीमद् इति श्री ब्रह्म तत्व प्रकाशिकायां चतुर्थाध्यायस्य तृतीय पाद देर बाय इन ब्रह्म तत्व प्रकाशिका विच इज द ब्रह्म सूत्र वृत्ति बाय भगवान सदाशिव ब्रह्मेन्द्र द थर्ड पाद ऑफ द लास्ट फोर्थ चैप्टर फलाध्याय इज ओवर विल मूव ऑन टू द फोर्थ पाद चतुर्थ पाद इत्थं पूर्वस्मिन् पादे सगुण ब्रह्म उपासकानां कार्य ब्रह्म प्राप्ति कथिता What has been narrated and established in the earlier pada, the saguna brahma upasakas alone get karya brahma. Saguna brahma upasakas get karya brahma only, not shuddha brahma, one. And saguna brahma upasakas alone, not pratika upasakas, get karya brahma. Brahma loka is attained not by any other upasaka, only by saguna brahma, brahma upasakas. Aduna nirguna brahma vidam, however, To contrast this with a jnani, brahmajnani, who has understood the tatpare vishaya of all Upanishads, Veda Sara, as to Advaita is the satyasya satyam, it is the ultimate truth. Paramarthika satya is nirguna brahma is the swarupa of the jiva. One who has understood that is nirguna brahma with. So now, aduna, निर्गुण ब्रह्मविदां फॉर दीज ज्ञानीज ब्रह्मज्ञानीज निर्गुण ब्रह्मज्ञानी तद्भावम अभिधातुम अयम पादा आरभ्यते तद्भावम इज व्हाट ब्रह्म भावम दे डोंट अटेन ब्रह्मलोक दे अटेन ब्रह्म भाव ब्रह्मत्वम एंड अटेनमेंट इज फिगरेटिव एज वी हैव सीन मेनी अ टाइम देयर बाय दिस पादा इज फोकस्ड टू निर्गुण ब्रह्मज्ञानीज The first adhikarana there is sampadyavir bhava adhikaranam. There may be a repha missing here. So you have to add there. There may be a typo in the earlier print. Sampadyavir bhava svena shabdat. Sampadyavir bhava svena shabdat. There also may be a space in the earlier part. Because svena is third case singular. It appears so. So shabdat was separated but it is a samasa. So sampadyavir bhava svena shabdat. These are two separate words and svena and shabdat is a samasa samasta pada so svena iti shabdat svena shabdat svena iti shabdat svena shabdat asmat svena shabdat so svena is a quotation therefore it is in samasa with shabda so svena is a shabda in the shruti which is quoted as the hetu therefore svena shabdat what is the acharya saying for that we need purva paksha we'll go to purva paksha first and then come back पादांतरत्वादस्य न पूर्वाधिकरण संगति अपेक्षा देर इज नो पाद संगति अधिकरण संगति बिकॉज पादास हैव चेंज देर इज अ डिफरेंस इन द पादा देयरफॉर नो सच संगति इज एक्सपेक्टेड हियर अत्र पूर्वपक्षे स्वर्ग मोक्षयोर अविशेष सिद्धांते विशेष इति फलभेद पूर्वपक्षी सेज दैट ब्रह्मलोक स्वर्ग इत्यादि दे मीन मोक्ष इटसेल्फ सो देर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन मोक्ष और स्वर्ग स्वर्ग प्राप्ति इज मोक्ष And what you say moksha, you got moksha, there swarga prapti should take place, that itself is moksha. There is no difference between the two. Whereas Siddhanti says that there is vishesha, there is a difference between moksha and swarga. So moksha, jivan mukti can happen here and now in the बॉडी इट्सेल्फ दी ब्रह्म विद निर्गुण ब्रह्म विद ज्ञानी ब्रह्म ज्ञानी गेट्स जीवन मुक्ति मीनिंग देयर इट्सेल्फ इज फ्री एंड इन क्रम मुक्ति वी सी दैट इन ब्रह्मलोका वन गेट्स ज्ञाना एंड इज फ्री देयर विधेय मुक्ति फॉर बोथ इज आफ्टर दी मर्जिंग ऑफ दी बॉडी सो इन ब्रह्मलोका द मर्जिंग ऑफ द बॉडी इज एट द एंड ऑफ द कल्पा वेर एज इन दिस लोका द जीवन मुक्ता गेट्स विधेय मुक्ति वेन प्रारब्ध इज ओवर सो संपद्य आविर्भाव स्वेन शब्दात सो पूर्व पक्षी ब्रिंग्स अप अ क्वेश्चन एज टू दि परम ज्योतिरुपसंपद्य स्वेन रूपेण अभिनिष्पद्यते देर इज छांदोग्य मंत्र देर इन द एट चैप्टर वेर the brahma chaturmukha brahma himself is a teacher virochana and indra are asura devata virochana and indra who is the leader of devata so not asura devata asura asura adhyaksha and deva adhyaksha they both are students virochana leaves earlier at the first mention of what is atma even while showing koshas or making the shishyas have viveka there is some basic teaching given initially that itself is taken as idam ittham and virochana leaves the gurukula meaning leaves brahma's house by understanding that the sharira itself is atma and that is what he teaches asura so it is an understanding that everyone who thinks sharira is atma even today they are all asuras Even among manushyas, those who think that sharira is itself atma, they are all having asuri bhava. They are all asuras because Virochana has taught them saksha. He has misunderstood and he has taught that atma is nothing but this sharira itself. Therefore, you know, do whatever it takes for the sharira. That is the atma. Do whatever it needs, and that is what the asura pravritti is. We see that happening today itself among masses. Whereas Indra stays back. Rather he also lives with Virochana but you know midway through or a little distance ahead because of chitta shuddhi he has a doubt how can it be this is not the case I have to question it and he goes back and stays in the gurukula every time you know this shishya visits the first time also when they visit 32 years of brahmacharya palana has to be done meaning they have to be antevasi there 32 years only then they get some jnana some teaching there so brahma says you stay here in the gurukula so they have to have brahmacharya vasa for 32 years then he gave some basic teaching virochana went back indra went out and came back because he had left he is not antevasi anymore therefore brahma asks him to do brahmacharya vasa of 32 more years then the next stage of teaching So every section of teaching is preceded by 32 years of brahmacharya and this continues with Indra he goes out comes back in the, at the final stage he says that you have got enough so you don't need to stay for 32 years stay for 5 years and then I'll give you the final teaching and then that is the 8th chapter of chandogya last chapter of chandogya so there swena rupena Abhinishpadyate is the 12th section, in the 12th section, third mantra of the 8th chapter. So what is that about? To that, Purvapakshi's interpretation is Swarga and Moksha are not different from each other. Whereas Siddhanti says, Svena Shabda, Sampadyavirbhava, Sampati, Sampadyavirbhava, Sampadya, have Sampadya Svena Rupena. So Sampadya Avirbhava, Avirbhava is manifestation. How is the manifestation? How is the presence of the jnani? Svena shabdat, it is svena sarupena ityartha. So there is no attainment of swarga, brahmaloka, ityadi. Jivan mukti is established by that. As to one remains as brahma, svena rupena, he remains in brahmatma swarupa. This is the jnani's phala. Param jyotihi sampadya. Having attained this param jyoti is atma jnana. प्रकाश रूप ज्ञान चैतन्य रूप हैविंग अंडरस्टूड वंस चैतन्य स्वरूप एज अखंड चैतन्य संपद्य आविर्भाव आविर्भाव इज हाउ मैनिफेस्टेशन और वॉट एवर वॉज द अर्लियर मिक्सअप दैट मिक्सअप इज गॉन नाउ सो ही हिमसेल्फ रिमेन्स एज हिमसेल्फ इन हिज ओन स्वरूप दिस इज द ज्ञानी ज्ञानी फला, दैट इज द सूत्रार्थ. फर्दर इन दी वी हैव फिनिश दी अर्लियर टू लाइन. सो एष संप्रसादो अस्मात् शरीरा समुत्थाय परं ज्योतिरुपसंपद्य स्वेन रूपेण अभिनिष्पद्यते इति श्रूयते. सो देर इज अ श्रुति विच सेज वॉट एष संप्रसादः, दिस पर्सन हु हॉज एक्चुअली अस्लीप सो फार, वॉट हैपन्स, ही हैज बीन ब्लेस्ड विथ ज्ञान एंड वेन ही बिकम संप्रसाद, वेन ही वेक्स अप टू दैट ही बिकम संप्रसाद टू ब्रह्म ज्ञान, देन अस्मात् शरीरात् समुत्थाय. वॉट हैपन्स वेन ही लीव्स द शरीर ऑल्सो, वॉट हैपन्स देर. सो विदेह मुक्ति इज ऑल्सो फला. वॉट इज द विदेह मुक्ति फला देर, इन विच मैनर इज ही देर? वी विल टेक इट एज जीवन मुक्ति ऑल्सो, बट अस्मात् शरीरात् समुत्थाय इज मेन्शन. सो हैविंग लेफ्ट द बॉडी वॉट हैपन्स टू हिम? वॉट इज हिज आविर्भाव? डज ही अटेन स्वर्ग? पूर्व पक्षी सेज यस ही अटेन स्वर्ग बिकॉज अस्मात् शरीरात् समुत्थाय इज मेन्शन, हैविंग लेफ्ट दिस बॉडी. सो हैविंग दिस नाउ इन जीवन मुक्ति ऑल्सो वी कैन एक्सप्लेन अस्मात् शरीर समुत्थाय इन इन वंस ओन अंडरस्टैंडिंग. दैट इज वॉट समुत्थाय, देर इज नो रियल लिविंग द बॉडी, देर इज कॉग्निटिव लीविंग दी बॉडी, एसोसिएशन विद दी बॉडी, दैट इज ऑल्सो अ मीनिंग पॉसिबल देयर, एंड जीवन मुक्ति कैन ऑल्सो बी एस्टैब्लिश. बट परंज्योति ही उपसंपद्य स्वेन रूपेण अभिनिष्पद्यते. वन अटेन्स इन वन ओन फॉर्म, वन अटेन्स वन सेल्फ, हाउ? परंज्योति उपसंपद्य. सो लेबंत पदा इज गिवन परंज्योति उपसंपद्य, हैविंग अटेन परम ज्योति देर वा इति श्रूयते. सो देर तत्र किं स्वर्गादौ सुकृतिनः इव निर्गुण ब्रह्मविदापि आगन्तुकेन केनचित् विशेषेण अविनिष्पत्तिः उत आत्ममात्रेणेति संशये. वेदर दि अटेनमेंट एंड मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ वन ओन स्वरूप आफ्टर लीविंग दि बॉडी, विल टेक दि लिटरल मीनिंग राइट नाउ. वॉट हैपन्स देयर? स्वर्ग प्राप्ति इज देयर और नॉट? सो स्वर्गादौ सुकृतिनः इव, सुकृत सुकृति आर और सुकृति इज आर सुकृतिन इज द प्रातिपदिक. सो दि सुष्टु कृतिन, सो दोज हु हैव डन पुण्य कर्म लाइक देम इव स्वर्गादौ निर्गुण ब्रह्मविदः अपि आगंतुकेन. इन स्वर्ग दि पुण्य कृत कर्ताज अटेन दैट स्वर्ग. सो तत्कृत स्वर्गादौ सिमिलर टू स्वर्ग इत्यादि प्राप्ति जस्ट लाइक दैट निर्गुण ब्रह्मविद अपि आगंतुकेन केनचित् विशेषण अभिनिष्पत्ति. सो स्वर्गादो अभिनिष्पति, दैट इज हाउ दि अन्वय इज. इन स्वर्ग एट्सेट्रा देर इज मैनिफेस्टेशन, मीनिंग वन विल अटेन स्वर्ग एंड मैनिफेस्ट देर केनचित् विशेषण. सम विशेष मे बी देर, देर मे बी डिफरेंसेस एज टू वॉट दि पुण्य पर्सन हु हैज डन पुण्य और दोज हु हैव डन पुण्य आर सुकृतिनः. सो सुकृति ने इव दे अटेन स्वर्ग एंड देयर सम इज विशेष, इज सम विशेष भोग. सिमिलरली निर्गुण ब्रह्म विधा अपि, वन हु इज निर्गुण ब्रह्म ज्ञानी, फॉर हिम ऑल्सो इज देयर केनचिद विशेष अभिनिष्पत्ति, सम काइंड ऑफ अ विशेष इन स्वर्ग इट्स सेल्फ. स्वर्गादु सम अदर लोक, स्वर्गादु स्वर्गलोक ब्रह्मलोक इत्यादि. एंड वॉट इज दट? आगंतुकेन, which will not be there forever. Swarga is not forever, bhoga is not forever. Similarly, brahmaloka is not forever, bhoga is not forever. Is similar the case of nirguna brahma with also, like those who have done a lot of punya. Uta atma matra niti samshe, or will they remain as brahma, brahmatma alone, meaning there is no loka gati involved, there is no attainment of swarga, brahmaloka ityadi. When such doubt comes up, फलत्वा विशेषा स्वर्गवद अभिनिष्पत्तिरिति पूर्वपक्ष. पूर्वपक्षी सेज देर इज नो डिफरेंस इन फला मेंशन्ड एनी वेयर, देर फोर वॉट विल हैपन? उपसंप स्वेन रूपेण अभिनिष्पत्ति, देर इज नो डिफरेंस इन फला मेंशन्ड देर. वॉट इज ए फला? सो फला इज नॉट स्पेसिफिकली मेंशन्ड इन विच लोका, एंड फॉर ऑल ऑफ दिस वी हैव सम लोका. सो स्वर्गलोका वा भवतु और वॉट ब्रह्मलोको वा भवतु, देर इज विशेष प्राप्ति ऑफ दि लोका, मीनिंग विशेष मे बी इन दि लोका, बट इन दि फल देर इज नो विशेष. फलत्व विशेष ऑल ऑफ दीज विल अटेन स्वर्ग इत्यादि लोकास, वेदर इट इज अ ब्रह्मज्ञानी और अ पुण्यकर्मी. सिद्धांतस्तु वेरा सिद्धांति सेज इट इज नॉट सो. वाय? संपद्य संपद्य मीन्स वॉट इन द मंत्र परम ज्योति उपसंपद्य देर वॉट डज इट मीन संपद्य स्वप्रकाशम आत्मानं साक्षाद अनुभूय दैट्स वॉट इट मीन्स. इट मीन्स दैट बिकॉज परम ज्योति इज द्वितीय एक वचन इट इज नपुंसक ज्योति इज अ नपुंसक शब्द ज्योतिष शब्द. सो संपद्य मीन्स हैविंग अटेन्ड वॉट परम ज्योति स्वप्रकाशम आत्मानं. What is that Param Jyoti? Param Jyoti, Jyotishampi Jyoti is Swaprakash Atma, one's own Atma, Sakshad Anubhoya. Sampadya meaning not real attainment. It is figurative, meaning not associating with anything or any kosha as oneself, having no Tadatmya Sambandha with anything other than one's own Swarupa, and therefore Sakshad Anubhoya. Being oneself is the meaning there. Sakshat tena eva atma matrena avirbhava vidvan avirbhavati. So avirbhava is vidvan avirbhavati. Manifest in which form? First he was manifest with koshas along with one's own swarupa. Now there are no more kosha sambandhas left. Mithyatva drishti has taken place. It has all become tuchha rather. And he considers himself as Atma, he remains as Atma. There is no other sambandha. Kutaha, why do you say swasdi purvapakshi? Svena rupena avinishpadyate iti swashabdad ityartha. Swashabdad is svena shabdad. Because of swashabda being mentioned in svena, therefore swa means oneself. So in one's own form, that is the meaning, in one's own swarupa, that is the reason. Because there is no attainment of swarga where you need to go to get your own swarupa. Your swarupa is your own self. You don't need to travel to know your swarupa. You are in your own swarupa. You don't attain your swarupa going elsewhere. You cannot even do away with your swarupa here or in other loka. You cannot give up what you are. What you are, you, that is your real swarupa. That is why it is called a swarupa. Swarupa is that which never changes. How will it be attained in another loka? Whatever is going to be attained in another loka as swarupa, that is here also right now. So you don't need to travel for swarupa. That's why Shruti says svena rupena, meaning in one's own nature one remains. He manifests in one's own nature, meaning was he not manifest in his own nature earlier? Oh, he was, but not only in his own nature. He was also connected to other non-swarupas also, non-nature. It is not his nature to be emotional. Satchidananda Brahma does not become emotional. So that emotional mind, buddhi, individuality, bheda, all these are samsarana, janma, mrityu, ityadi, shadvikara, all these are for all the koshas that he considered as himself. Therefore, along with his own nature, he had a lot of noise which had mixed up. All that is gone now, and then phalahetuka anumanam that Purvapakshi has brought in, moksha nityatva shruti baditam iti bodhyam. So the anumana that the Purvapakshi is using, what is the anumana that he is using? The anumana is phalahetuka, the anumana which has led to his phala analysis of swarga prapti. What is that? As to it will be agantuka. Agantukatva is the resultant analysis of the Purvapakshi. So he is making an anumana. What is the anumana? Nirguna Brahma Vidaha Agantaku Agantuka Rupavan. Nirguna Brahma Vit. Nirguna Brahma Vit Agantuka Rupavan. So what is his Rupa? Agantuka Rupa. He will go to some loka, come back. Who is that Nirguna Brahma with? Nirguna Brahma Jnani. Why? Phalatva. Because it is a phala mentioned. This rupa is mentioned as phala. Avirbhava. Swayam Jyotihi Upasampadya Svena Rupena Abhinishpadyate is not figurative for the Purvapakshi. He says that this rupa is attainment of some rupa in Swargaloka. Therefore, Svena Rupena Abhinishpadyate means that is the phala. So phalatvat, because it is the phala mentioned in Chandogya Shruti, Swargavat, Swarga is also phala. Swarga is a phala mentioned in Shruti, and Swarga, one who attains Swarga is Agantuka Rupavan. Similarly, one who attains one's own Swarupa also is also what? Is Agantuka Rupavan. Who is that Nirguna Brahmavit, Parabrahmavit? That is not the case, says Siddhanti. Why? Because that Anumana is Badhita. That Anumana is countered by what? Moksha Nityatva Shruti itself. Meaning, Moksha is one's own Swarupa. What is Moksha? Remaining in Satchidananda Swarupa. So, Svena Rupena shows that the Swarupa, Svena Rupa or Swarupa is what? Is Satchidananda Rupa. That Brahma is one's own very nature. And that has never gone. And since it has never gone, moksha will be what? That is moksha. Moksha will also be nitya. Never gone means it's nitya. So moksha is nitya. And moksha nityatva shruti will counter this phala hetu ka anumana. What is phala hetu? Phalatvat hetu is no longer there. It is not a phala. Real phala it isn't. What is it? It is one's own swarupa. Iti bodhyam. This is what we have to understand. Further, the second sutra is introduced by saying, Nanu swarupatmaka mokshasya sanatanatvat kaf punaha purvavasthato vishesha ataha. Purvapakshiya, so you are saying that moksha is nitya, swarupa is nitya, it is not phala. Then pray tell, what is the difference of this avastha, moksha avastha as claimed by you, which is attained by being in one's own swarupa, as the Chandogya Shruti says, versus what was his own Swarupa earlier. What is the difference? Swarupa does not go, this is your claim. So, Swarupatmaka Mokshasya, Moksha is now. And you are saying Moksha is Nitya, because Sanatanatvat, Nitya. So, Swarupa, one Swarupa, because Moksha is one's own Swarupa, Swarupa is Nitya, therefore Moksha is Nitya. And thereby, Kaha Puna Purva Avasthato Vishesha. Compared to this Jnani's earlier Avastha, what is the difference now? Earlier also he had Swarupa, now also he has his own Swarupa. Moksha is Nitya, what is the difference? He is getting nothing. What is he getting? Iti Puru Avasthata Kaf Punaha Vishesha. What is the difference between the earlier Avastha and the current Avastha after Jnanotpatti? Pray tell. Ataha Siddhanti says Muktav Pratijnanat. Muktav Pratijnanat. Siddhanti says, oh, but there is a difference. What is the difference? Now he is mukta. Earlier he was not mukta. Why? Because pratijna is like that. Shruti makes a pratijna and then reveals the swarupa. Till the Shruti reveals the swarupa, doesn't reveal the swarupa, this jnani is not a jnani. Jnani was an ajnani earlier. Although his swarupa was mukta, moksha, he was not mukta because he was bound with other koshas. Now he is mukta. So that is the vishesha. So compared to earlier avastha, what is the difference? Earlier there was kosha sambandha, now there is no kosha sambandha. Why so? Pratijnana, because that is the pratijna. We'll show it in the same section of Chandogya, or rather same chapter of Chandogya in a different section. Bhagavan Sadashiva Brahmendra elaborates this as Puram avasthatre kalushitaha samsari iva avatishtamano api. Iva has been used. As though samsari, this nitya moksha swarupa one jiva was purvam samsari iva. He was as though samsari, as though transmigrating from body to body to body to body to loka to loka. He has been continuing so from anadikala. Why so? What is hetu? Hetu garva visheshana is given. Avastatre kalushitaha. He had Shadavikaras and he had these three avastas, avastatraya. He was going from Jagradavastha to Swapnavastha to Sushupti Avastha, and then continuing across these three avastas, he was tainted by them as considering them as real. But really Sushupti is due to what? Shuddha Vidya. There is Avarna Shakti. That is Shuddha Vidya. Then its manifestation is Jagrat and Swapnavastha. So there is also Karya. Karya in the form of Sukshma Sharira and Stula Sharira. Where there is Sambandha which has caused Swapna and Jagratavastha, which he took literally. Oh, it is true. I am Baddha Jiva. In Swapna also he considered himself as Baddha Jiva because he didn't know it is Swapna. It is Mithya. He thought of all of this as in the Swapna Prapancha is real as Jagrata. Then in Jagrata Avastha he thought, oh, Swapna is all Mithya, but this Jagrata is real, it will never go away. So I am a Samsari. So Samsari, Iva, being tainted by दी थ्री अवस्थास ही वॉज कंटिन्यूइंग हिज जर्नी अनादिकालेन एज दो इव संसार इव अवतिष्ठमान बीइंग इन दैट काइंड ऑफ दैट काइंड ऑफ अ सिचुएशन रादर रिमेनिंग सो एज अ संसारी अपि इवन दो वॉट सर्व संसार अनर्थ व्रातात मुक्त देर मे बी ओनली वकार हियर रेफा वुड बी मिसिंग प्लीज ऐड दैट इफ यू हैव द अर्लियर प्रिंट सो सर्व संसार अनर्थ व्रातात मुक्त व्राता इज समूह अनर्थ समूह देर ग्रुप ऑफ एडवर्सिटी इज सर्व संसार ऑ एंटायर संसार इज नथिंग बट ग्रुप ऑफ एडवर्सिटीज सो फ्रॉम दिस सर्व संसार अनर्थ व्राता ही इज मुक्त व्रातात मुक्त नाउ आफ्टर ज्ञान आफ्टर द टीचिंग ऑफ द उपनिषद परितः प्रद्योत मान पूर्णानंद आत्मना अवतिष्ठते इति महानयम विशेष व्हाट इज द विशेष युवास महानयम विशेष देयर इज अ ह्यूज डिफरेंस दैट इव मेक्स ह्यूज डिफरेंस एज दो ट्रांसमाइग्रेटिंग व्हाइल ही वाज नॉट ही वाज एज दो संसारी व्हाइल ही वाज नॉट बट इव मेक्स अ ह्यूज डिफरेंस संसारी इव He was not a samsari, but he considered himself as samsari. So for him it is not eva. In truth it was eva, but he does not know that. That eva makes a huge difference. Now he knows eva. As though I samsari I was, but I am not a samsari. I will not be a samsari. And never was I a samsari. I was never segmented jiva. Never did have three avasthas. Never did have any kosha sambandha. Koshas themselves are not there. I have never been anything but Brahma. So paritaha, completely what? Pradyotamana purna anandam atmana avatishtate. Purna ananda atmana. This atma swarupa is what? Purna ananda. Not segmented agantuka ananda with gradations in ananda like priya moda pramoda. So he is purna ananda swarupa. And prakasha, swaprakashamana. स्वरूप ऑल्सो प्रद्योतमान कंप्लीटली सेल्फ शाइनिंग काइंड ऑफ आनंद आनंद डज नॉट नीड एनी विषय सो आनंद इज ऑल्सो शाइनिंग फोर्थ ऑन इट्स ओन एंड ही इज ऑल्सो शाइनिंग फोर्थ ऑन इज ओन विदाउट एनी सत्ता फ्रॉम एनी वन एल्स सो सच्चिदानंद स्वरूप इज द मीनिंग हियर इन दैट वे ही कंटिन्यूज टू बी अवतिष्ठते इति महानयम विशेष नाउ ही कंटिन्यूज टू बी सो And in his understanding, he was never anything else. Therefore, there is a huge difference in the earlier and the current status of the jnani. Kutaha, kutaha punaha ayam avagamyate. Pura Pakshi asks, where do you conclude, from where do you have such conclusions? I don't see that. Where do you see all this? Please show. So, pratijnana says Siddhanti. There is a pratijnana, pratijna made. Pratijnana, this kind of a pratijna has been made. In the same Upanishad chapter that you are referring to, we'll show you, says Siddhanti, etam tveva te bhuyo anuvyakhyasyami iti sakala anartha vinirmuktasya eva anandatmana vyakhyayetvena pratijnana dichyartha. When Virochana and Indra approached Chaturmukha Brahma, they did not approach to know non-atma. They wanted to know their own Swarupa. Swarupa was never changed. Even they knew that Swarupa cannot change because that is what Swarupa is. If anyone tells you this is your Swarupa, that Swarupa is never going to change. They know. But what was advertised by Brahma? Etantveva te bhuyo anuvyakhyasami. What has been advertised that itself he is going to teach again and again and again. Teach me something new. Same teaching. Finally he is going to teach your Swarupa only. Why does that teaching need to continue across chapters, across sections? Why did Virochana not get it at the first teaching? Why did Indra take so many teachings to get it? Just like Shvetaketu also took 9 Upadeshas of Tattvamasi in the 6th chapter. Now in the 8th chapter also similar thing. As long as Chitta Shuddhi is not there, no one will get it. So Virochana did not get the Swarupa Jnana at all. Indra kept on going back to the Acharya for teaching again and again till he did not get it. Avagati Paryantam Jnanam. And what was taught? Whatever was made, whatever was the Pratijna of Brahma, same thing was taught. Chaturmukha Brahma made a Pratijna, that itself he has been teaching. And then इन दी नाइन्थ सेक्शन ऑफ दी एट चैप्टर ही सेज एतम त्वेव ते भूयः भूयः इज पुनः अगेन आई टीच यू व्हाट अनुव्याख्यास में अगेन आई टीच यू द सेम थिंग दिस वेरी आत्मा आई टीच यू विच इज योर स्वरूप He has not taught anything else. It is not that initially he said, I'll teach you Swarupa and then he taught something else. He has been teaching the same thing again and again and again. Therefore, whatever was one's own Swarupa, that itself becomes clear towards the end. With additional Chitta Shuddhi, with additional Shravana, with additional Manana and Nididhyasana, same thing is taught again and again and again, bombarded with Shabdata repetition also. And arthata repetition also. Nothing else is there. Other than Sachidananda Brahma, nothing is there. What else to teach really? In Keno Upanishad, the Acharya says we don't even know how to teach. Other than what has been taught by our own Sampradaya Acharyas. Meaning this is the only methodology we know. Neti Neti is the only prakriya. Chitta Shuddhi has to be there. You have to wash yourself out of earlier samskaras. And then what you are, that shines forth. Only as what you are, not as anything else. Earlier it was shining forth as something else, now it does not. That is the Vishesha. So Mahan Vishesha is seen in the same Pratijna and the same teaching that follows. Iti Sakala Anartha Vinirmuktasya Eva Anandatmanaha. That Anandatma is the subject matter which is free from all Anarthas completely. In the earlier to Jnana stage, this is not completely free. So, Ananda Swarupa Atma is not free from all the Kalusha, all the Sakala Anartha, all the Anartha. Therefore, the same Swarupa when it is taught without the association, it becomes clear. There is no change in Swarupa and Sakala Anartha Vinirmuktasya Eva Anandatmana. Only that Anandatma alone is being taught. Vyakhyayetvena pratijnana ityartha. That was the pratijna and that is the conclusion also in all Upanishads, not only this Upanishad. Nanu karyam jyotirupa sampannasya katham muktattvam. This is the last sutra in the adhikarana. I'll just finish it off very short. Nanu karyam jyotirupa sampannasya katham muktattvam. Now the Purvapakshi is saying param jyoti upasampadya. That jyoti is what it is. Jyoti is light, some kind of a light that you see here. So the Laukika Jyoti Prakasha is what Purva Pakshi thinks it means. Karyam Jyoti, created Jyoti. Upasambhanasya, one who has attained that, Katha Muktattvam, for him, how can there be Mukti? You are talking about Mukti, Moksha, how can he get Mukti? Just by looking at some Jyoti, you will not get Mukti. How does that work? Ataha Aha, Siddhanti says, no, Atma Prakaranat. Atma Prakarana. So what is meant by Param Jyoti Rupa Sampadya? Param Jyoti is in the meaning of Atma. Having attained one's own Atma as Atma, one remains as Atma Svena Rupena. That is the meaning there. Seeing nothing else, nothing else. That is the Atma Swarupa. Seeing oneself as Jyoti Swarupa, Param Jyoti Swarupa, Chaitanya Swarupa. That Chaitanya is my own very nature, which is not segmented, Akhanda it is. That is the meaning. So Jyoti meaning is Atma. Why? Prakarana. Because that is the section. It is Atma Prakarana. It is not Agni or Surya Prakarana where you have some other Karya Jyoti. So Atra Atma eva Jyotihi na bhautikam tejaha. The tejas, the prakasha, teja rupa that you see in manifest form in loka, whether as Surya, fire, etc. That is not the meaning of Param Jyoti here. Atma alone is the meaning of that word Param Jyotihi. Why? Ya Atma Apahata Papma. So Ya Atma Apahata Papma. So Apahata Papa. Papma is Papa. For whom the Papas have gone away. Meaning Papas do not taint that Atma even if the Sharira Manaha have been doing Papa through that. There was a Tadatma Sambandha and one considered oneself to be tainted. But there, this Atma is that which has absolutely no Papa at all. Ever. Never did it have Papa. That is the Prakarana there. Iti Atma Prakarana Ityartha. So 871 started with Ya Atma Apahata Papma. And 893 is not going to talk about some other Jyoti. It is talking about Atma Jyoti itself. Jyoti means Atma Swarupa. In Swarupa it is Jyoti Rupa. This is the meaning. Thereby this Adhikarana is over. The next Adhikarana is Avibhagena Drushtatva Adhikarana. We will look at that in the next Patha. आम्ना यंतिक संसिद्धम आदि मध्यांत वर्जितम आनंद घनम आपूर्णम आत्म ज्योतिरुपासमहे नमस्ते धन्यवाद
धन्यवाद आपको जी, नमस्ते।